I think building cultural appreciation is directly brought in by the community. So getting community and elders involved in your classrooms is key. First of all, it's really important to reconciliation, but it's important that you get elders and community members in to model that process for you and kind of bring in those teachings. Another thing you could be doing to develop cultural appreciation is something as simple as the seven sacred teachings, bringing that in the school. And it's all about character education, but it's developing that vocabulary in your classroom so that students just start talking that way. It just starts becoming the accepted normal way to speak. So cultural appreciation comes through many forms, but one example of that is having the land acknowledgement statement in your school. And by continuing to say that, it just becomes the norm and it becomes a part of that appreciation for Indigenous people in their past. So if you think about holistic, you think about what is this doing for me as a whole? So what is it doing for the whole child? So reading literacy, you can think of things, how is this changing my physical self? What is it doing for my mental, my reading? What is it doing for my emotional? How does it make me feel? And also, what does this book do for me spiritual? There's lots of things we do spiritually that make us feel good, whether that's listening to music, whether that's laughing with friends, but books and literacy can do that for a child and start thinking holistically, what is this doing for your classroom?
In terms of being classroom specific to passing on cultural traditions, I think it comes back to bringing in the knowledge keepers, sharing that wisdom, seeing the language, feeling the language, bring in as many knowledge keepers as possible. So for example, on Veterans Day, bring in a war vet. You can celebrate your storytellers, your authors, your weavers, your midwives, your farmers, your market growers. Bring in real people who are living and breathing their craft. Also, one of the things that I've uploaded on this site is a traditional calendar. What I would love for students to do in classrooms is really take note of what's happening in your community and what's happening outside of your community. And you'll be able to see that online. So when I was little, I always wondered what's happening in our community, what's happening out on the land. And I was really happy to go to the elders. So what I would love to see in every classroom is you know, it's so beautiful when you see students witnessing their teachers learning alongside with them. Also, get out of the classroom as often as possible. What about cooking classes? What about observing the annual round? So let's say you're in Heiltsuk territory or Heishauk territory in Waeglisla, British Columbia. If there's the Rowan kelp, that all students are out helping with the Rowan kelp. If it's moose season, all students are out hunting and gathering together. If it's tanning moose hide season, all students are working together with their teachers and learning side by side by the knowledge keepers. That's what I would love to see. If it's the full moon, for example, I would love to see students dropping tobacco and harvesting yarrow or sweetgrass or sage or buffalo sage or rat root. So being actively involved in the season and what the season offers. More storytellers, more learning together, hands-on experience, hearing from the best of the best, and creating a community calendar where you honor what's happening in your community and outside of your community as well, my opinion.
Great ways of exploring cultural appreciation may be experiencing local cultural events such as powwows, jigging events, looking at your local Métis Nation, attending some sort of function. How can you be part of a round dance? How can you be part of a drumming circle? A beading activity, bringing in local specialized educators who can navigate dancing, like shawl dancing. How can you navigate kind of those everyday cultural experiences? Maybe creating relationship with a local First Nation. Maybe creating some sort of exchange program between primarily a provincial school and maybe a band-controlled school. How could you create relationship Could you start with email? Could you start Skyping? Maybe you could start doing face or Skyping with a school in New Zealand. So really looking outside of our local context as well, but also drawing into it. I think a big focus right now, or it's become en vogue, is literacy of the land or learning from the land. And really, it's very, very old. And part of a huge disconnect for many urban Indigenous children, and I would say for all children, whether you're Indigenous or not, is really getting kids back to the land. And how do we, you know, partnering with people who have those teachings and that knowledge, you know, maybe children could learn how to pick sacred medicines or learn how to pick something like sage. So really accessing the land, how could they attend a cultural camp? Could they be part of a cultural camp for maybe two or three nights? And honing in to those local Indigenous elders within your community, those knowledge keepers, those language keepers, and providing that opportunity for students. You know, we call it outdoor education, but essentially it's literacy of the land. You may call it environmental education. It's literacy of the land. So how can we look at that literacy? How can we read the land? And how can we teach our children to read the land? My dad has often said, if you're not on the land, you're not going to know how to survive. So he's speaking about reading the land and having that inherent knowledge. And there will be a time when we need to know how to do that.